I was a police officer with the military police and then 27 years with Saskatoon. I retired in 2013 with the rank of sergeant. For most, it was like a fire brigade. You're going from one fire to the other and you weren't really thinking about the root causes and how to change it. In the rank and file, and even a couple ranks higher than that, I don't think it was foremost in your thought because everything was immediate and had to be dealt with. When I first came here, of course, they were anchored with two bars, the Barry and the Albany, and which were just like little epicenters of crime in Saskatoon. A lot of gang, a lot of drug activity, lots of violence. Prostitutes actually openly working the corners. Now you look and everything is quite modern. It's changed a lot. If you can get a dialogue going with somebody, no matter, you know, unless they're really high or very violent at the moment, usually you'll be able to identify at least some factors that led to him or her being arrested. A lot of hard feelings come from street checks. When officers check people on the streets, explaining why you're doing it makes a big difference. If they weren't involved in crime, usually it was pretty positive. If they were involved in crime, well, they just didn't like you because you were going right where they live. That's one of the breakdowns in policing that I see in the past 15 or 20 years when I look at other jurisdictions, is where the only time people see the police is when there's trouble. And it's really important that not be the only time you're seen. Getting out of your car, walking around, talking, it makes a big difference in the way people perceive you and perceive your police service.